God took his sheep up the mountain to graze beside the lake. As he stared into the deep, black, icy water, he saw a beautiful girl emerge.
I'm not.
sleep. I'm listening. Bruises. Oh, sorry. So the shepherd looked long and hard at the three girls, but one of them wiggled her toes and tail. Not that, not here, not her, another bronze murdered by a father's touch, by the touch of care. Like all the others, each day they come, more and more pitiful stories, abject little dramas, but now a creeping tide of death, whose cause I search and search. I write, I ring, but everywhere silence. The sound of suffering, letters unopened, the telephones ring in empty rooms, in the library depths on the shelves, laboratories closed, the officials have locked their doors. We are cut off behind a curtain of rain. The dying can only gather beside the lake and sing. But I will go to them, and they will know and act, and they will not turn away, and they must not close their eyes, and they will not avert their faces. I shall bring the dying before them, and they will see and know and act, for am I not the doctor of Malmö?
Are now officially expunged. they were found to be divisive and a barrier to efficient continental policy.
If you had a map.
Under emergency measures, all administrative maps are classified. Are you trying to obtain classified information? Your local office will tell you your number.
All the officers in our zone are closed.
That is impossible. It constitutes an irresponsive rumor.
This is a serious matter of public health.
You require an appointment with a relevant zonal health officer. There are no common concerns. After marriage, no one
Not at all, My case is practically a sentence of exile.
Exile!
To the front, of course. And from a front that does not exist, who may return?
A doctor's work should well be at the front.
You are perhaps naive about a means of war, and so they usually send expendable youths.
Who dare not speak, dare not speak unpalatable truths?
Doctor
of Medvai,
defy my condition.
Your health is astonishing.
I, the father of sickness.
You are the father of war and war.
Doctor, you are surely not going to moralize. Define my condition.
The impotence of the powerful is a commonplace.
As common, perhaps, as the disappearance of doctors.
That trivial threat cannot shrink to silence a voice that feeds its fury on the sight of a nation in sickness.
What are you, fraud, imposter, terrorist?
A doctor?
Why have you come, religious fanatic? Another deranged ethnic group.
I am a doctor. Don't press the button.
No, you are not a murderer. But are you a healer?
Notes. I saw there when I had kissed a bruise. Outside the fish shop, I slapped his face. His boy danced round him, patting him on the back. Now it's covered, covered. This is no lie. These blackened husks, they die. And gathered by the lake, the dying sing.
I see that you are genuinely moved, but I must learn when not to hear. So many facts, so many pleas, so many. I shut my ears, pursue the policy, the treaty, the continent, for these three aims, shut out the counterclaims of protest, no matter what one pains, so long as these three vital aims.
Tiny blow, and the bruise will spread.
With her policy, the treaty, the continent, before these three clear granite blocks, all the ghastly complexities of blood, belief, and money shatter, and all are nothing, and nothing upon these hands.
When the continent, this nameless mess, this abstract treaty, this bloodless policy, with which so much blood is spilt, shall harbor nothing, nothing but the mutilated husks of human beings.
Then I have failed, perhaps I've been placed, my memory defiled, my name effaced. Not be lailed, deflected or delayed, and certainly not toppled from my throne by rumors of disease from some unnecessary zone. You've had your say. But now this little chap is full. For your sake, it would be astute if we record a substitute on strictly medical lines. Security would be appalled if they played your indiscreet charade. Of course, they probably installed a second machine by now. That is the impotence of the powerful.
Thank you. Helplessness, that's my word for it. I can do nothing for you. I am helpless on the path of policy. And though I am compelled to leave your little nation to its fate, I find you left behind a longing to communicate. It's 2 a.m. On sleepless nights I turn to Gainsborough, and there are 3 hanging in my dressing room. After the eastern capital succumbed, a long and bitter siege, the survivors systematically devoured the corpses. They came my way a general's apology for unforgivable delay.
A second girl came at a wedding. She could not stop crying.
Into his subjugated countryside. He had the power to civilize by force. If nature dared rebel, he'd change its course. He threw up dams, he cut down swathes of trees. We visionaries must do as we please, or else be slaves to mediocrity. Filth, muddle, futile debate, the purists of this or that endangered race, the prating jurists, fanatical believers, or that mundane, despicable majority, the idle, compromising, lion-feeding life, whose only wit is somehow to survive. No, no, cut through, cut through, make straighter lines, join, force, fuse, melt down infinite heat, and break them out in brand new molds.
And the third war, was the annual, and she laughed and laughed and laughed, pealing cascades of laughter. And he, so embarrassed, hissed to be quiet and rapped her knuckles.
Try to let my hasty fingers feel beneath the petticoats of this proud woman, flaring her nostrils like a mating horse, and yet about her mouth the merest whisper of a smile. I hear the silk scratch and the fire she moves, prancing wild, imperious, effervescent, rampant, that great mane of impeccable hair, poised to tumble in a wave. All right, all right, it's just a wig. Orders to General Dupré. The cleansing of Zone 6 will begin at 4 a.m. tomorrow.
Thank you.
on no account reveal your name. Take off your clothes.
I do not need to do that.
You are beautiful. It is a mistake. It makes me sad.
Sadness is also a gift.
Don't touch. Don't touch unless instructed. And do not be afraid. I shall probably hurt you.
No, you will not need to do that.
It is stifling. There will be a storm. You'd better go.
You know that is not necessary.
There is something in your hair.
It is a fish.
And your eyes glitter.
The stone is red and full of stars.
Your skin.
And beneath the cliffs, there is the sweetest pasture. I've brought you some bread.
I am not a beggar.
You are less than a beggar.
I had forgotten the taste of bread.
You have forgotten to offer me your wine. But I will drink it from your scented pine combine, and in the storm you will not notice when you drown.
Let me go with you in the lightning of a summer storm.
Again and again,
the sun will
rise.
Again
we shall pray,
the sun will rise.